who knows what the future holds, right? But
yes,
what is the greatest disappointment you've ever had with meeting someone famous and you're like, that person's an asshole? And what's funny is I just asked that question, and then as I spoke it, I'm like, oh, well, what's mine? And then I remember Dragon Con last year.
And it's the same thing. I mean, well, that was almost like Anchorman. Like, I'm not even mad. Like, I'm kind of impressed you could be that big of a bitch. Like,
it was crazy.
Like, you can come to a fan convention where you're just dealing with fans.
So we remember last year at Dragon Con, we get the brilliant idea that we're going to do this thing called Not My Line, which, by the way,
yes,
I just got a notice from GoDaddy that notmyline.com is expiring, and I chose not to renew it.
Yes.
But, like, we are panicked about what we're going to do for Dragon Con, and then, like, at 2 in the morning, the most brilliant idea in the world comes to us. That it's like, wait, we got all these sci-fi luminaries. Maybe we can go around and get them to quote lines from movies that they were not in. So it's like, you know, let's get Buck Rogers to say, may the force be with you, that kind of thing. And we decide we're going to...
We had LeVar Burton say, you know, Luke, I am your father. We had Zorak doing, that's not a knife, this is a knife.
Yes, yes.
But yeah, so it was really, really good. And like, by and large, considering the fact that like, they are coming out here to these conventions to make money on autographs.
Yes, and,
like,
and
that is...
And for goodwill, of course. You know, they like interacting with the fans, and it's ostensibly to grow their brand and get personal connections.
It's a win-win on all levels. But, like, we are not ignorant of the fact that there is a profit motive.
Different people seem to have different levels of being okay with that. For example, the guy who does Space Ghost Coast to Coast voice. And, I mean, they were very, like, we got 3 words into our pitch, and he's just like, oh, so what you're saying is you're not going to buy anything. And then eventually he's like, no, we'll buy. Just can we get some audio of you saying something?
Yeah. We make our way over.
And I should point out. Yeah, I should point out that you and I are drinking while we're doing this. Like, we've got these Dharma Initiative non-alcoholic beverages is what they're labeled as. So you got the sci-fi angle, but really they're natural lights in there, which one of my favorite moments was when we handed one to LeVar Burton and he looked and he goes, he gets excited and he's just like, this isn't an energy drink, is it? And I'm like, nope, it's beer. And he immediately cracks it open. He's like, good. And started drinking our beer.
Now there was, I mean, like, LeVar Burton was very, 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 very cool. And LeVar Burton was one of the few people, because we really relied on Chat Realm to spread the word on Twitter, was very...
Tuned in.
And
like, he knew what we were talking about. He was like, oh, that's that whole Not My Line thing you guys are doing, right? What is that?
Yeah. He was, and I don't know how long he'd been out there or what his schedule was. He was a weary fellow.
Oh, my gosh.
By the point that we ran into him, and like, us giving him a beer was like,
I love you. Relief. Yeah.
Sweet relief.
But,
well, meanwhile, like, Richard Hatch was like the nicest guy on the planet. Like,
oh, yeah.
He's like, you know, we're doing, you know, the thing, and he's like trying to think of a line, and he's like, so guys, you know, like, what sci-fi TV shows are you into? And we're like, Battlestar. He's like, oh, besides Battlestar. Like, he like actually wanted to have like a conversation. He's like, I really like Firefly. Do you like Firefly? And we're like, yes, I love Firefly too.
That's another thing that should be clear. It's like, while we're the ones who have this idea, it's one thing to have this idea, like, let's go around and ask all these famous people to go on camera saying these weird lines and participating in our horseshit shenanigan. And then it's another thing to find yourself, like, I seriously was drinking for courage to go approach these characters who I remember from second grade, man. I worship the stuff that these guys worked on. And it was terrifying to go up and risk rejection for our idiotic idea. Because that's another thing, too. They're very clear. They're like, do not try to get an interview at the autograph signing thing.
Yes.
And so we walked a line. We weren't trying to get an interview. We just wanted to come up and say hello and pitch our thing and ask if they wanted to participate. And we figured if no, then so be it, right?
Yeah.
And so,
but, I mean, no harm in asking.
Right. But it's one thing to say that, but then it's another one to go and risk rejection by your heroes repeatedly. So we're doing a pretty good job of, the first one we did was Mark Singer, and he was cool with it. And then we went and I think it was Counselor Troy. Buck Rogers was an amazing one. The guy who played Buck Rogers.
Yeah. We did really, really well Next Generation wise.
Oh my gosh.
We got Geordi, we got Data, we got Counselor Troy. No, we killed it TNG style.
Yes.
But
But then,
there comes a point, and also like at this point, we have our pitch pretty well down.
Yeah,
like well, and we can suss out like whether or not they're down for it, and we're like totally like, hey, listen, if you don't want to do it, it's totally cool. We will walk away. It's not an interview. It's a 1 second thing. It's a fairly popular podcast. We're going to be doing a live show later tonight, and we want to be able to show it. Would you be down to do this? Right. And at this point, like we had done it enough times, and by the time that we get to the problem child.
Yeah, yes, yes. And that's the toughest thing, right? It's because out of all of them, it was, oh, and then we even ran into Adrian Pazdar from Heroes, who I had seen when I was out working with Greg Grunberg on that pilot thing.
Yes.
But
he was like too busy or something.
Yeah, I forget what it was. He was like, and that's the other thing is it's weird. It's weird to convince people that you're too busy to do this when there's no line at your booth. And talking to Counselor Troy, like at first, like we walked, there was only one person in line because we didn't want to wait a really long time and they get rejected. So we saw that there was only one person in line with Counselor Troy. And so we go up to talk to her and like she is just chatty as can be, really, really engaging us until there's one person behind us in line. And then all of a sudden she's like, so what can I do for you guys? And I realize that she doesn't want to be the person who has nobody at her booth. And so that's why she's chatting it up with everyone, just making small talk until there's enough people behind that it's like she'll never be without a person.
She's a smart cookie.
She is. She's smarter than the character she played on that
and
show.
She was really incredibly nice. Unlike this person, mystery person. Now do we go through the play by play?
Yeah. Well, no. Yeah. Okay. So we go up and she has not much of a line, but out of everyone, she's the only one, and we love the franchises that she's associated with. You know, she is a fantastic actress, and so we go up, and it's the only one where they have a handler before they hand over to it, whatever. And we're like, well, they're like, where's your pictures? What do you want her to sign? And we're like, oh, well, we just had this thing we wanted to pitch to her. We host a show on the internet. And she's just like, I don't know.
Which, by the way, the handler, we kind of even prefer. Because at that point, it's like, if we're going to get rejected, it's going to be a conversation between like two regular people. We don't got to get rejected by her.
Right.
You know, so it's like, hey, listen, so this is an idea. Is this something that she'd be into? Like, if it's not, it's totally cool. Like, we're not going to press it or anything. It's just, you know, we're just, you know, asking everybody. So we're asking you.
Right.
And she is like, I don't know. Let me go ask her. So she goes, asks her, comes back and says, she didn't quite understand it. Can you go over there and tell her? But at, like, at this point, it's like, okay, well, she was interested enough to not just be like, oh, what the fuck? Just tell them to fuck off.
Yes. Yes. Like, And so we walk over and we start explaining it, and like all the signs she gives is just like, you know, yeah, no, this, I get what you're doing. And then like
she likes it. Like she keeps asking about the idea.
Yes.
Like she keeps asking like, okay, so what's the idea? And we're like, same thing. Not my line.
And then she's just like, oh, I get it. So like you would have me say, I'll be back, that kind of thing. And as she's nodding, we're like, yeah. All three of us are nodding. And she goes,
and meanwhile, like we have, We're explaining like other people that things that other people have said, and she's like laughing about it.
Right.
Like,
right.
It was, she was so on board.
Right.
Until this idea.
And then we're like, yeah. So you want to do one? And then just with no hesitation, she goes, no. and then just like she pressed a button and the awkward field just exploded all over us. And then she just sat there staring at us. And then we're like, Firefly was awesome, but your crappy V series will be gone in a year. Good day, madam.